Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wal aqibatu lil muttaqeen. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين والصلاة والسلام على خلفاء الراشدين المهديين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كلامه المجيد وفي فرقانه الحميد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجس أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن مثل أهل بيتي فيكم مثل سفينة نوح من ركبها نجا ومن تخلف عنها هلكا. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في شان حبيبه ومحبوبه مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله سيدنا مولانا محمد اللهم صل على سيدنا سيدنا مولانا محمد حسن شهيد جهر قيا حسن شهيد كربلاء حسن شهيد جهر قيا حسن شهيد কারবালায় জয়নালাব দিনের কন্দন এদিদের ঈদখানায় আল্লাহুম্মা সাল্লি আলা সাইয়্যিদিনা মাওলানা মুহাম্মাদ ওয়া আলা আলি Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad Nabir Jamne Jahar Dil Bhai Ey Dorat Kandena Nabir Jamne Jahar Dil Bhai Ey Dorat হাশরে ভাইজান তারা নবীর দেখা পাবে না আল্লাহুম্মা সাল্লি আলা সাইয়্যিদিনা মাওলানা মুহাম্মাদ ওয়া আলা আলি সাইয়্যিদিনা بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا شافع المذنبين الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رحمة للعالمين
Respected brothers and sisters who are watching this blessed program, I like to give you a lot of thanks as you are watching one of the blessed programs which has been arranged by one of Islamic TV channels, SPS TV, Shaktopoder Shainik. I am here to say a few words about the ranks, about the dignities of respected family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are called Ahl Bayt. Why did I choose this topic? Because everybody knows that this is the month of Muharram, which is called Shahrullah al-Muharram. Muharram is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muharram is one of the sacred months. This is Allah's kindness. This is Allah's mercy that He has given us 12 months. We everybody know a year makes, a year is made by 12 months. And this is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of Muslim family, most of Muslim children, they don't know Arabic month's name. As a Muslim, we have to keep a good relation with Arabic months, with Arabic language. We know Arabic is the mother tongue of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, I love Arabic language for three reasons. First, this is my mother tongue. Second, This is the language of Quran al-Karim. And third reason, it will be the language of for everyone in Jannah. At the day of judgment, everyone will talk with one language that is called Arabic. So we have to keep a good relation with Arabic language. If we don't know Arabic language, we won't be able to recite Quran al-Karim. We won't be able to read namaz. We won't be able to send durood upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is our responsibility to learn Arabic language. If we know Arabic language, we will be able to recite Quran al-Karim, which is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the greatest book. This is the final book. This is the best of all books. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Khairul kalami kalamullah wa khairul hadi hadi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best kalam is the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the best guidance is the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the best guidance? What is the best ideology? No doubt, this is the ideology of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the full explanation of Quran al-Karim. In the last sermon of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he delivered a beautiful and short speech. In this speech, he said, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ أَمْرَيْنِ لَمْ تَدِلُّوا مَا تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَالسُنَّةَ رَسُولِهِ. Oh my companions, I have left two things. If we hold them first, if you hold them first, if you follow them, if you establish the rules of these two things in your family life, private life, social life, and political life, you will never be misguided. These two things are Kitab Allah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Undoubtedly, this is Quran al-Karim. Best book, greatest book, the greatest constitution for Muslim. Respected brothers, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have left two things. One is Quran al-Karim and another one is Sunnah Rasulillah, the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is our responsibility to follow the ideology of Quran and the follow of ideology of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From Quran al-Karim, I have recited one of the beautiful verses, important verses, which has been taken from Surah Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُزْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. No doubt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make you complete, pure and sacred, and He wants to remove all kind of impurities from you, O Ahl-e-Bayt. all my family members who are Ahle Bayt, who are the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they should have at least two conditions. First, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have blood relationship with those people. Second condition, they should love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with complete iman, and the diet upon their beliefs, their iman. They are called Ahle Bayt. In this regard, we can say Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, one of the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhuma are the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Abu Talib are not the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because though Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have a blood relation with these three persons, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Abu Talib, but they were not on proper iman, perfect iman. They didn't believe in Allah. They didn't believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They didn't love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with complete iman. That's why, though they have a blood relation of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as they had no iman, that's why they are not called among Ahle Bayt. Ahle Bayt are those who used to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything, and they used to lead their life according to the ideology of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they have a blood relation with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why they are called Ahle Bayt. In this regard, we can say Hazrat Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu is from Ahle Bayt. Hazrat Jafar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is from Ahle Bayt Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Jainul Abdin is from the Ahle Bayt Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, what is the ranks of Ahle Bayt? What are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding the respect and honor of Ahle Bayt? You have heard the recitation which I recited just before a few minutes from Surah Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. O Ahle Bayt, O my family members, undoubtedly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make you complete pure, and He wants to remove every kind of impurities from you. No doubt the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are pure, are sacred, they are very respected, they are very honorable family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am saying one of the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which has been reported by most honorable angel Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. He said, I have traveled this dunya from east to west, but I didn't see the best family like the family of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I didn't see the best person like the person of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Prophet our messenger, our heart, our light of our hearts, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the best of all prophets, all messengers. He is the greatest one. He is the best one. He is the last and final prophet and messenger in this dunya. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't create Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He would not create anything. We are very lucky. We are very glorious that we have got a prophet and messenger like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every moment, as we have become the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. نَحْنُ سُعَدَى لِأَنَّنَا وَجَدْنَا دِينَنَا الْإِسْلَامِ نَبِيَّنَا مُحَمَّدًا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ دُسْتُورَنَا الْقُرْآنِ. We are very glad that we have got the greatest religion, which is called Islam. Islam means peace. Islam means sacrifice. Islam means submission. As we are Muslim, we have to submit ourselves to the Lord of the world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm saying the regards, the honors of the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm saying another hadith which has been reported by one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas. He said, when one of the verses of Quran al-Kareem, نَدْعَ أَبْنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ وَنِسَاءَنَا وَنِسَاءَكُمْ وَأَنفُسَنَا وَأَنفُسَكُمْ ثُمَّ نَبْتَهِلْ فَنَجْعَ لَعْنَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. When this verse has been revealed upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَدَعَى حَسَانْ وَالْحُسَيْنْ وَعَلِيًّا وَفَاطِمَةً. When this verse has been revealed, he called Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He called Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. He called Hassan and Hussein. And after that, he said, Allahumma ha'ulai ahlu bayti. He said, O Allah, these are my family members. Subhanallah. So who are ahlu bayt? This is very clear to us. Ahlul Bayt, the respected family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love them too much. Once, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was delivering his speech. Suddenly he saw his grandson Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to him by running. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stopped his lecture, his khutbah, and he picked him up. He picked his grandson up on his shoulder. And he told, Ana uhibbu fa ahibba ya Allah. O Allah, I love him, so you love him. Subhanallah. He used to love Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu too much. He used to kiss on his body, on his lips, on his neck, on his shoulder. When Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu was born, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after seeing him, he started crying. One of Mahila Sahabi, Fazl, he saw this situation, this condition, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is crying after seeing his grandson Hussein radiallahu ta'ala who was born. He asked, Ya Rasulullah, why are you crying? Your grandson was born. This is the matter of great happiness. You will be happy. You will be glad. But why are you crying? He said, you don't know whatever I know. This is my grandson. But this is very regret thing. This is the matter of great sorrow that once some of my followers, misguided followers, will kill my grandson. That's why I'm crying. So from this hadith, this is clear to us that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows many things, whatever we don't know. He knows some unseen thing, which is called ghaib. This is the special gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers and sisters, I can see a lot of viewers already joined this program. And most of you commented here beautifully. If we have time, we will try to read out your comments, inshallah. So I am saying some of the ranks, honors, dignities of the respected family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ مَثَلَ أَهْلِ بَيْتِي فِيكُمْ كَمَثَلِ سَفِينَةِ نُوحٍ مَنْ رَكِبَهَا نَجَى وَمَنْ تَغَلَّبَ عَنْهَا هَلَكَ. The example of my Ahlul Bayt to you, like the example of boat of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, like the example of sheep of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Most of us, we know the story of Nuh alayhi salam, the story of the sheep of Nuh alayhi salam, the boat of Nuh alayhi salam. For saving the time, I'm not going that topic. I'm not going to explain that story. I just want to say what our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say regarding the honor and respect of the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave a beautiful example here. Inna masala ahli bayti ka masali safinati nuh. Man rakibaha naja wa man taghallaba anha halaka. The example of my family members are like the example of the boat of Nuh alayhi salam. Whoever wrote on the boat of Nuh alayhi salam, they became safe. And whoever didn't ride on this boat, they became destroyed. The same way, if we love and respect the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we'll be surely safe, we'll be free from hellfire, we'll be able to stay on paradise with the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But if we don't love and respect the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will be destroyed. We will be disregarded here and hereafter. We will be dishonored and insulted at the day of judgment. If we give trouble to family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the cause of creating the pain of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It gives trouble to the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give trouble to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the trouble of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا. Indeed, whoever give trouble to Allah and His Messenger, لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must curse upon them, must curse them. وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا, and He has prepared a great punishment, insulting punishment for the day of judgment. Respected viewers, I'm saying some beautiful hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding the family members of him. He said some most important words about Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Who was Ali? What is the dignity of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu? If I go to explain, I need at least some of the days. But I am saying some important hadith in short. He said, to Ali, Anta minni bimanzilati Harun min Musa illa annahu la nabiyya ba'di wa la rasula. Subhanallah. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma reported, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, O Ali, you are to me in place of Harun alayhi salam to Musa alayhi salam. That means, you are to me like Harun alayhi salam. The relationship of Harun alayhi salam to Musa alayhi salam is brother. Harun alayhi salam is brother of Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam is one of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same way Harun alayhi salam is one of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Ali, you are like Harun alayhi salam, like one of my brothers. But you are not prophet, because after me there is no prophet, no messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ma kana muhammadun aba ahadin min rijalikum walakin rasulallahi wa khataman nabiyyin wa kana allahu bi kulli shay'in alima. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the brother of you, but he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walakin Rasulullah. Rather, he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa khataman nabiyyin. And he is the last and final messenger. So this is clear. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was created before everything. But he has been sent this dunya, last of all prophets and messengers. So our prophet, our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, last and final messenger, subhanallah. This is one of his characteristics, his qualities, his dignities. I'm saying another hadith regarding Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Aliyum minni wa ana min Ali. Ali is from me and I am from Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, Ana Madinatul Ilm wa Aliyyum Babuha. I am the city of knowledge, and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu is the gate of this city, this town. In another hadith, he said, Ana Darul Hikmah wa Aliyyum Babuha. I am a house of wisdom, and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu is its door. Subhanallah. He said in another hadith, لا يحب علي منافق ولا يبغضه مؤمن. The hypocrite person won't love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and the believer won't give him trouble. Subhanallah. He said in another hadith, من سب علي فقد سبني. Whoever said Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, as if he said me. So we should love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. If we love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, it means we have proven that we are among believers, mu'min. Now I am saying some hadith regarding Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. What our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about his youngest daughter Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, loving daughter Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Fatima tu bid'atun minni, faman aghdabaha aghdabani. My daughter Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha is the part of my body. Subhanallah. Whoever gives her trouble as if he troubled me. And whoever loves Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha as if he loved me. He said regarding Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, a hadith which is normally read by Imam Sahib in every Friday in second Jummah. Most of Muslims are familiar to this hadith. This is very well known hadith to Muslim. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Fatimata Sayyidatu Nisa Yahlil Jannah. No doubt Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha will be the leader of all women in paradise. He said, O people of the world, please love daughters because I am a father of daughters. Whoever loves Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha as if he loved me. Now I am saying some of hadith which has been told by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding his two grandsons, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. He said, Inna al-Hasana wal-Husayna Sayyida Shababi Ahli al-Jannah. No doubt, Hassan and Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhuma will be the leader of all young men in Jannah, in heaven. So no doubt, two grandsons of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be the leader of all young men in Jannah. They will be the leader of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They will be the leader of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They will be the leader of all prophets and messengers except Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyida Shababi Ahlil Jannah. all men will be at the young age in Jannah, no doubt. Once our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw an old man was reciting Quranul Kareem, and he said to him with joke, no old man will enter into Jannah. No black people will enter into Jannah. No old lady will enter into Jannah. Then black man started crying. Old man started crying. Old lady started crying. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam smiled and explained his words like that. He said, every believing people, men and women, will go to Jannah though they are old, but when they will enter into Jannah, they will be in young age, 18 years old people, 18 years young people. So Imam Hussain and Imam Hussain and Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhuma will be the leader of all young men in Jannah. Subhanallah. This is the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Hassan, Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, they've got the equal regards of Sahaba-i-Kiram, who are called Sahaba-i-Kiram. Sahaba-i-Kiram are those respected people who saw Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who led their life according to the ideology of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who believed in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and established on that till they pass away, till the last day, last moment of their life. They are called Sahaba-i-Kiram. Imam Hassan, Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, undoubtedly they are Sahaba-i-Kiram. They have got the equal dignities of Sahabi, Sahaba-i-Kiram. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah, Allah fi ashabi la tattakhizuhum ghardam min ba'di. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ وَمَنْ أَبْغَدَهُمْ فَبِبُغْضِي أَبْغَدَهُمْ. We are not allowed to abuse Sahaba-i-Kiram. We are not allowed to call them bad names. We are not allowed to swear them. We are not allowed to give them trouble. Rather, we should praise Sahaba-i-Kiram. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Khairul Quruni Qarni, Summa Allazina Yalunahum, Summa Allazina Yalunahum. The best era is my era. Era of me, era of Sahaba-i-Kiram. After that, the era of Tabi'in. After that, the era of Tabi'ut Tabi'in. Subhanallah. Three eras are praiseworthy. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam certified that these three eras, three ages, are best age. Respected viewers, respected Islamic brothers. So we should love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by loving his relatives, his family members. He doesn't want anything from us except we should love his family members, his nearest and dearest people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Shura, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. O my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, I don't want anything from you except the love of my dearest people. It means our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't anything from us, but he wants that we should love his nearest and dearest people, his relatives. We should love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We should love Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. We should love his grandsons, his family members. I'm saying one of beautiful hadiths which has been reported, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. She said, once I saw Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went out from his house, and he has been covered by a black blanket. After a few minutes, I saw his grandson Hassan radiallahu ta'ala who came to him running. He covered him with his blanket. After that, his grandson Hussain radiallahu ta'ala who came out running to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He covered him with his blanket as well. After that, his daughter Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha came out to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He covered her with his black blanket. After that, Sher-e-Khuda, Asadullahul Ghalib, Asadullahul Ghalib Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He covered him with his black blanket. He covered them four with his black blanket. And then he said, Allahumma ha'ulai ahlu bayti. Allah, these are my family members. Ana uhibbuhum fa ahibbahum. I love them. Please, you love them. So we should love those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love. We should love those people whom our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love. Once Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha started crying. It was the time of last moment of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the angel of death, Azrail alayhi salatu wa salam, came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take his soul away. It was the last moment of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, last stage of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave this news to Fatima, O Fatima, this is the time that I have to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the time I am going to pass away. This is the time I am going to die. When Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha heard this news, he started crying too much. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pulled her to closest to him and said, Fatima, oh my dear daughter Fatima, stop crying. You have a good news. That is, after I pass away, after my death, after a few days of my death, you will meet with me. He also said, oh Fatima, you have a good news. At the day of judgment, you will be the leader of all women in paradise. Then Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha stopped crying and she smiled. My dear friends, I explained some of verses and some of hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the dignities of the respected family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From these verses and from these beautiful hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we could understand easily it's our imani duties to love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, Hassan Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. And we should show the hatred upon the soldiers of Yazid who killed Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his 72 soldiers, family members from Ahle Bayt in Karbala Maidan, very cruelly, very brutally. The cruel soldiers of Yazid killed Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu and the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Karbala Maidan. We should be on behalf of Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We shouldn't stay with those people who are praising Yazid and his soldiers, who say Yazid radiallahu ta'ala anhu, na'uzu billah. As a Muslim, we can't say like that, Yazid radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We can say, Yazid lanatullahi alayhi. May Allah bless us, give us ability to love Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, including all of the family members of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we should show hatred on Yazid and his soldiers. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.